nights in the middle of June. Heat waves been faking me out. Can't make you happier now. Sometimes all I think about is you. Late nights in the middle of June. Heat waves been faking me out. Can't make you happier now.
Usually I put something on TV, so we never think. Our reflections clearly in Hollywood, laying on the screen.
You just need a better life than this. You need something I can never give. Fake water all across the road. It's gone, now the night is come. But sometimes all I think about is you. Late nights in the middle of June. He always been faking me out. Can't make you happy or not.
Hey guys, it's Caleb. Welcome back to the channel. I am so glad to have you and to show you this awesome video of a new product from Metalcloak. That is the Metalcloak rear bumper for your 21 Ford Bronco. Now, an issue I have with my Bronco after installing the 37s is I have some rubbing right here on the rear bumper. I've also hit the bumper quite a bit on some rocks. And while a rear bumper upgrade isn't the first upgrade I'd recommend, if you're gonna put on bigger tires, if you're gonna hit the rocks really hard, I do recommend eventually upgrading that rear bumper. Now, Metalcloak has a whole lineup of Bronco parts. They've just come over to the Bronco side of things after being involved in the Jeep community for a long time. They're local to the Rubicon, they hit the trails hard. They make some quality products that I run on my Jeep. Highly recommend you check them out. I'll include the link in my description below. But in this video, we're going to be installing their rear bumper. I also have their trailing arms and their track bar coming as well. We're going to go over all the nuts and bolts, how it fits, how it looks. We're going to give you measurements before and after clearance. We're going to go over the design, the quality, the fitment with 37s. We're going to show you all of it as well as the install. So first off, we're going to be taking off the spare tire to get better access, and that's going to use three bolts that hold the spare tire on, and that's going to use a 19 millimeter socket. So we'll show you that. Stay tuned. Oh, and if you don't mind, drop a comment below what you think of Metalcloak, what you think of Broncos, or just any questions you might have. It helps the algorithm, helps me out. And yeah, stay tuned. I'm juggling a lot of things here. I've got this mic. My wireless mic is no longer working, and yeah, that's not big enough. Already messing up. So first things first, you're gonna take your 19 millimeter socket, and we're gonna start by removing the spare tire, like I said. Hope the audio turns out well. I'm having issues with mics still, trying to find a right setup. I have this wired mic, which I'm trying right now, but it seems to have a lot of popping. So we'll see. I'm also a little worried about how heavy this 37 is gonna be. Not as bad as I thought, honestly. All right, let's get that out of the way. While I have this off, I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna just clean it up a little bit, add my extension bracket for the rear brake light, and then we'll go about doing all the bumper stuff. Okay, I threw that bracket on there real quick to relocate the third brake light. It's a DV8 bracket, it's super cheap. Took me 5 minutes to install. It's four bolts, that's it. Yeah, got that, paid full price. I did get a little discount on the bumper, not a big one, just a small one. I paid over $900 still for the bumper. So just disclaimer on that. I will tell you though that I do give honest reviews because, I mean, DV8 sent me their inner fender liners for 50% off, 50% off. And if you look at my video on can 37's fit on a mostly stock Bronco, I don't exactly recommend them. So You can trust me, I'll give you honest reviews on all my stuff that I put on here. I only put on stuff that I like and that I want to run, and the rear bumper is one of those. So I did get a small discount, nothing big. It was like $50 or something like that off, but you're going to get my honest opinion. So that's on there. Now we're going to get to the rear bumper. We're going to remove the plastic bumper and go from there. Okay, next we're going to take a 10 millimeter socket to this trailer plug. If you don't have this, then obviously you don't need to do it. Cool. And then we're going to disconnect the harness as well and go from there. So after you take that bolt out, this whole mechanism just kind of pulls out from how it's mounted there in a slot, and then it just dangles. And then we're going to disconnect the wiring harness for the parking sensors on both sides. It's just a tab you pinch and pull it out. Okay, so far the hardest part is disconnecting these bumper sensor wiring. The clip has so much mud and debris in it, I can't push it in because it's facing up. It's hard to tell, but all the mud has been coming down in here and collecting, so I can't pinch it in to pull it out. Another issue I'm seeing, look at that. The wiring is rubbing on the rear stock bumper, Ford one, and causing fraying. There's actually fraying in the wiring from rubbing on this plastic over time, and that's no changes that I've made. That's from Ford. So once I get this stock bumper removed, I'm gonna tape that up and make sure that doesn't go all the way through, because that's not good. All right, so under the bumper, we have two 18 millimeter bolts, and then this 13 millimeter bolt that we have to remove. So we're gonna do that on both sides. Something I'd like to note too, just so we can measure the difference. Right now, it's about a thumb width on the bumper gap. So we'll see what the Metalcloak has. We also have 21 3/4 inches for the height right there, the clearance. Obviously it was lower where the shackle was. Then if we come over here, we got that gap, and we got the difference in height here. We got the difference here, which is 3 inches at the bottom, and then about 4.5 inches at the top. And then we're also gonna come through here and disconnect all my sensors, which is just clips holding in place, plastic clips. So take your time, be careful. Don't break anything, but it just pulls out. Okay, so we got the wiring harness off for the sensors. It's pretty easy. There's tabs on each of these sensors. And on these tabs, you just pry them open and they pull right out. The hardest part were these white Christmas tree clips. I had to use pliers to get underneath and pry them up because they didn't want to come out on their own. The black ones, they come out just by pulling on them, really easy. But other than that, it was pretty simple. It took me about, I don't know, 2 minutes. So get that off, set your harness aside, set the bumper aside. And now on to assembling the Metalcloak bumper. So I'm working on the driver's side here. You'll take your bumper cap, you'll get one of these braces, and each one only goes, they only go one way, so it'll be easy to find which side they go on. But you'll see two bolts and one bolt. The two bolts will go here and here, and then the one bolt will go on this side. This is gonna be a 3/4 inch. It's gonna go there. And these are 7/32. They're gonna go here. I will say the powder coating was perfect. Like, the powder coating job these guys do is phenomenal. No issues, feels very tough. I don't want to ruin it too much right now. I'll ruin it on the trail, but not in my garage. Now I'll just tighten those three up and go to the next set. Okay, I'm just snugging these up. I'm a firm believer in Ooga-Dooga for torque. So that's what I'm doing. Ooga-Dooga. Ooga-Dooga. Just want to add real quick, guys, for whatever reason, this bottom bolt goes in really tight. It feels like you're cross-threading it. I've adjusted it. I've tried it in multiple ways. It's the same every time. This one goes in great. The big golden one goes in great, but this one just feels like really tight at first, like you're cross-threading it, and it did it on both sides. But once you get past a certain point, it opens up and does much better, and it's not cross-threading, I checked. So just keep in mind, it's gonna feel like it's cross-threading. Double check, of course, that it's not, but it appears to be normal. The after product should look like this. Nice and flush fit, no gaps. Looks good. Okay, what we're gonna talk about here. So we have these D-ring mounts. They're nice and sturdy, and they bolt to the bumper end caps, which is going to be bolted to here with two bolts. The end cap is welded there and there. The welds are really good, and this is going to essentially run in through this hole and bolt up like so to the end cap. So use your imagination, I guess, or your experience on how strong that is. I'm not a metal guy. I'm sure it's strong enough to hold it. I'm curious how these end caps are going to mount. So, because the pulling power is going to be on these end caps. So we'll see how these end caps mount. The welds look great though. Okay, so for these D-ring mounts, you're going to use these silver bolts that are going to go in. I noticed the holes are really, really tight. So I recommend clearing them before you bolt them up, just to get some of that tightness away, because it'll be hard to install them with as tight as they are. And I think it's from the powder coating, getting a little bit into the threads from what I saw. So just clear them out and then it should be, oops, good to go. The thing I noticed is it said 22 millimeter socket for these silver bolts, but I don't know why they use standard and metric for the same bumper. That's kind of annoying, but I don't have a 22, so I grabbed a 7/8 and it's actually a perfect fit. So I'm hazarding to guess that it's a 7/8 and not a 22. I'm not sure why they say 22, but 7/8 will work just fine. Thank you. on this bad boy, since it's responsible for your recovery points, two oogadoogas should suffice. One, two. And there you have it. Next thing that we want to do is we have on the end caps these sections. Each section will get a clip. You just snap in. Well, did that one wrong. Stand by. Alright, well, whatever. I put it in wrong, but it should still work. You got these clips that just snap in. They should look like that. I put that in sideways. That's my fault, but it should still work. So put two on each end cap, and then we're going to put some one on each trim panel as well. One thing I notice is they tell you to put one of these on the trim plate. This is the trim plate, but they don't show you any good pictures of whether or not it goes on this way or this way, which is pretty important. They just say put it on. So I'm going to wait till further on in the install process before I put that on to know for sure if it goes on up or down. Okay, well, looking at this, how they have it, I'm assuming, because the picture again doesn't show it very well, but this trim plate comes on the end cap and it goes underneath the end cap there and over the end cap here, which would mean we take this clip and we put it like so. Assuming it goes on, of course. There we go. So we'll do that to both sides. Snug fit, exactly how I like it. Clips right on. The clearances and the tolerances on all this stuff is honestly top quality. It's very good. I'm impressed. Okay, next we're gonna take our bolts, the silver ones, 532nd head. I just found a 4mm and it fit right up, so that'll work. And we take the right trim piece, slide it in, hope that it gets right with how it's supposed to go. Yeah, that looks good. Do the other side. Okay, so now we're gonna install the end bracket or the end cap to the main bumper assembly. So we're gonna set the main assembly upright with these long slots on the ground. Take our end cap, line up the slot on the end cap with the slot on the bumper assembly, and then there'll be two holes with nutserts welded on the end caps. Line those up with the holes in the bumper assembly, and then take your bolt, put it through the hole. Just get it lined up and loosely put it on. Do your second one. Careful not to cross thread. And then we'll snug it up. And I'll show you afterward. Thank you. I would suggest for this part, go snug with these two bolts, but not all the way, because you still have to line up the slots on the other end when you install the bumper onto the Bronco. And there is some play in how this moves, so make sure just snug them up, but don't cinch down on them quite yet until we do the main install. Okay, as much as I would love to install some rear reverse lights right here, I don't have them. So they include this bracket, goes right there, caps it off, so it looks good. They include the nuts for it, but they don't include the bolt. They forgot to include my bolt. I went through everything and I don't have them. So I'll use something laying around to bolt that in place. Not a big deal, but for those that don't have equipment laying around or they just got what they needed to do this install, it's gonna be annoying. Okay, now we install these plugs for the sensors. Just squeeze right in, really easy. You can see I got my filler plate put on. So just install all these and then move on to the next. So an issue I'm having right off the bat is it says to take this wiring harness for your bumper sensors and install it back. That's my dog. And install it back. The issue I have is when you plug in these corner sensors, the two middle ones, they don't reach. So I'm several inches short on either side. It doesn't talk about that in the instructions. So I'm gonna take my razor, very carefully cut back, and see if I can get more space on the harness. But we'll see how that goes. So you'll see here, I've cut it open through the tape. And not only is it taped on the outside, it's also taped on the inside. So I'm gonna have to cut this tape all the way down, being very careful not to cut any wires. Okay, for this side, the passenger side, this loom actually continues that way towards the driver's side. So the only one we're gonna be able to adjust, and I'll adjust the camera so you can see, is this driver's side loom. So we'll just keep cutting back on this driver's side loom to give ourselves room to work with. Okay, so we got that stripped back enough. If you're worried about wiring, it's not that hard. You're just cutting through the tape, being careful not to cut any wire. So just take your time, use a nice sharp razor blade. And then afterward, we're gonna come back and we're gonna splice this loose wire that popped out while I was doing that back into the loom, and then just tape it back up. Put some tape on here for chafing, maybe some loom if I have it, and call it a day. Okay, so I have the bumper sensors all in place. I had some extra loom on hand, so I loomed that up. Hey buddy. So I loomed that up. The only thing I'd complain about is there's no spot to run the wire, so I might just tape it up out of the way, but there's no clips for retaining the wire. All right, the next thing we gotta do is take this that we've disconnected, it's the trailer plug harness, and these silver clips have to be pushed in so this metal bracket can come off. It's not that hard to do, but might take some work. This top one is giving me issues, so I got this thing I think there's just a rock yeah there's a rock stuck in there, so I got to get my pin and take that rock out. That rock out. should come off. Again, that side wants to come out. This side is easier, but still give me issues. I'll come back to you once I get this off, but these two clips push in, this middle bracket pulls off. Okay, use this to push on it some more. Came right off. Toss that to the side.
And now you take it. It only goes in one way. Clips right in place. Okay, let's try this. It's pretty heavy. I think it's around 80 pounds.
So you're going to take these brackets and these bolts. The brackets are going to go right here on the inside. Bolt going through it. And let it rest there. And that'll bolt into the bumper. The notches on this side are different than the notches on that side. I don't think it'll make a difference. Just, again, forward, strange. Then we'll mount the bumper, and then the old bolts that mounted from the bottom will be reused on the bottom of this bumper. Definitely recommend two people for this. Gonna have to loosen these two because they are in my way. Okay, a couple things to tidy it up now. I have to relocate this to plug into the back of that. When you're doing the install, remember to keep these two bolts on either side loose. And then preferably with two people. I did it with one though, and I'm not that strong. You put these, you reuse these old bolts, put them up through the frame. Do not tighten them all the way down, just make them snug enough so that it's touching the frame. And then come around back and you'll put these brackets here and you'll thread these in again, snug, but not all the way. Now, once you got those bolts snug, you're gonna wanna go around and make sure all your wiring is clear, everything's clear and nothing's rubbing. And then you can go ahead and you can start snugging down all the bolts. Put in all the mounting bolts first, tighten those, one, two oogadoogas, whatever you like. And then do those two bolts on the bumper, tighten those down. All right, so it's starting to get dark, but I did an ouchie. I was pushing that clip in and the clip does not want to push in. That clip was giving me a pain. I pushed it so hard, the plastic clip piece broke, and then ironically it slipped right in. So I'm taping it up to hold it in place. Hopefully that holds and the sensors work, but if not, I'm gonna have to get a new clip for these sensors. That's a Ford problem, not a bumper problem. And there you have it, guys. That's the bumper install. I really like the look. It looks great, feels great, there's no sag. Strong mounting points mounted to the frame in multiple spots. The end caps actually take the brunt of the The fours, the end caps, are the ones that are structural. They're bolted to the frame in multiple places. They provide a reinforcement bracket that goes behind the horn where the bumper mounts to. That helps with that. You've got multiple mounting points underneath to the frame and behind to the frame with those reinforcement plates. This is mounted to a bracket that's welded to the end cap. And then this middle piece is actually just bolted to these end caps with two bolts on either side. So it's more of a trim, quote unquote, piece. It's not built to withstand any pulls. That's all done through the end caps, which take the brunt of the structural force. This piece, I see why they relocated it up. I'm not sure if it's gonna fit with the spare tire. We're gonna find out. But it's relocated, so on any impacts, when this bends up, you keep your trailer hitch wiring good to go. I don't like how that looks now that it's empty. It's sticking out. It's kind of ugly. I might get that cut off. We'll see. It fits up really nicely on the sides. It matches my KVD fenders really well. The gap is good. The distance from bottom of the bumper to the ground is the same as the stock bumper, but with these cutaways you gain a lot better clearance behind the tire when you're coming down off rocks, which is where I was hitting on my stock bumper. I wasn't hitting here on my stock bumper. I was hitting here on this hitch, and I was hitting in the corners, but with this bumper I'm not gonna hit on the corners at all. So I'm really happy with it. It looks really good. There was the issue with wiring that I had, but that was with Ford, not with Metalcloak. And yeah, it's a good bumper, and it's one of the cheaper ones on the market, so highly recommend. Now it's time to go smash it on some trails. So just as I suspected, guys, this 37-inch tire completely covers up the trailer hitch connection. I can open the left side about two-thirds of the way, but not enough to connect something, and the right side can't open it up at all. So I'm gonna take that out. They did include a cover plate. I'm going to plate that hole and relocate the trailer hitch back to its stock location. Okay guys, that's all for the video. I appreciate you watching. I really like the bumper. It's like, I truly mean it. It's a good bumper. I'm excited to get out on the Rubicon and some other trails this year, going to Moab as well. Get out there, hit it on some rocks, and give you true feedback as I wheel it. But as far as the install goes, it was pretty simple. Just a few hiccups here and there, mainly on my end with some of the wiring from Ford. But it's a good bumper. I do like how, I know it doesn't fit with the 37, but that wiring harness, they give you the option of putting it on the stock location or their location as well. So you have options, which is always good to have. Hit me up if you have any questions. Hit that like button. I appreciate that. Send a comment of what you want to see next. And I'll see you on the next one. Take care.